Hello everyone, this is Pavan from SDET channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can work with Cypress command line. Then we will see some of the important features from dashboard services which are provided by Cypress. Now, the first thing is how to run Cypress from command line. So means we will able to run all the Cypress tests through command line. So to do this, what we have to do is first you need to capture the location of your root project directory. So like Cypress automation is my root folder. So I need to get the location of this. So here, this is my location of my project under C colon users admin Cypress automation. So first we need to navigate to this location through command prompt. Now let me open my command prompt, Windows command prompt, and you will see this window and just type CD and give this location. Now currently you are in project root directory. So from here you should able to run your a spec file. So every file I will consider as a spec file. So if you want to run them all of them together, we can just give one command here, that is Cypress run command. So we have to give command like this. Let me just write a command, Cypress run command. So but Cypress is installed on node modules bin folder, so we have to run the Cypress run command only from this particular location. So first we need to go to project root location or root directory. From there we have to issue this command node_modules/bin/cypress-run. So this command will run all the spec files one after another. Now let me just execute and press enter. Then it is starting all my spec files. Yes, now it is started run all my spec files. It will go and pick each and every spec file one after another, and each spec file contains either one test or multiple tests. So if you have a huge number of tests, it will take some time, and after completion of executing all the spec files, we will see the complete report here in the command line itself. All right, so my execution is completed. Now we'll see the final tabular form of report here. Runs are finished. So here, the lot of test cases got passed, and there is only one test got failed. So I have intentionally failed this test to see the failure in the report. And rest of them are got passed, and totally only one is failed out of 12 test cases, right? So this is a tabular form of report we can see in the CLI mode. So here we have run all the test cases as a group in one shot. So we have to just run one command, right? So that is Cypress run. Suppose I want to run only specific spec file, then how we can do that? So again, we have to give the same command, but additionally, we need to pass one argument, that is -spec, and in the double quotations, we need to specify the location of your spec file. So here, suppose I want to run my first test.spec.js, I need to provide the location of this file. So let's capture the location, just right click on the file and copy relative path and then paste it over here, right? And then quotations close. The same command, Cypress run, but here we need to add additional argument called -spec and specify the location along with your spec file name. Then it will run only the specific spec file. Now I have executed enter. Now this will run only one spec file, and the spec file contains one test or multiple test cases. All right, so now it is executed and also got passed perfectly fine. So far we have seen how we can execute all the spec files at one shot or specific spec file. Now we will see how we can work with the dashboard features. So to work with the dashboard features, we need to understand Cypress is provided a dashboard feature which is tightly coupled with the GitHub repositories. So GitHub is basically a repository, or the global repository where we can check in our code. So basically the Cypress dashboard is tightly coupled with the GitHub repository. So we can also generate the dashboard inside the GitHub repository. So to do this, what we have to do is we need to have a GitHub account, or you can have a Google account. So we can use both. So we can just go to your Cypress here, Visual Studio Code Editor. And first of all, we need to go to the test runner. So just go to the terminal and just go to the new terminal and let us open the test runner by issuing Cypress open command. So once you've given Cypress open command, it will open the test runner. So from there, we can configure our project in dashboard. So basically, dashboard is a cloud-based service and which is not locally saved. So here, Cypress is provided dashboard service as a cloud service. So what we have to do is we have to connect to the dashboard service by using a GitHub account. And once you run your test cases, and all the tests will be running inside the dashboard, and you will be able to see the results. Even you can see the screenshot and recorded videos, everything will be saved in the dashboard itself. And remember that the dashboard is not a local service. The dashboard is a cloud-based service, which is supported by Cypress. So here, these are my test cases I'm going to run. And here, if you see one more tab called Runs tab, right? So what we have to do is we need to just click on the Runs tab. So once you click on the Runs tab, so currently you have no recorded runs, it is saying, and we need to set up a new project. So for example, if you want to generate a dashboard, or if you want to see any recorded things in the dashboard, or if you want to see the results in the dashboard, we have to set up a new project, set up project to record. So this is the first thing we need to do. So if you set up this project in the dashboard, we can do a lot of activities later. So we can group our test cases, we can see our test results, we can see the recorded videos, we can see the screenshot, everything is available in the dashboard. So first of all, to generate the dashboard, we have to create a new project. So set up project to record. This is the first step. So once you set up our project, this project will be set up inside the GitHub repository. And once you created your setup, once you have set up your project in the GitHub repository, it will give you a project ID and also key. So these two are very, very important in the further. So because we can do a lot of activities in the dashboard, we can grouping, we can execution, we can do parallel execution, we can group our test cases, and we can run our tests in the CI environment. So to perform all these things, we need project ID and a key value. So as soon as we create, set up this project in the GitHub, then we will automatically get the key and a project ID. Now we'll see how we can do that. So here I'm just clicking on set up project to record. So once you click on this, it is asking for the login. So log into the dashboard. Just click on the login to the dashboard. So once you click on the login to the dashboard, it will automatically connect to the dashboard page here. So it will still be in the page. So it will automatically connect to the login page, dashboard login page. This is official URL of dashboard login page. But to log into the dashboard, so we have to use either GitHub account or we can use Google account. So any one of these you can use. So let me use my GitHub account. I already have my GitHub account. So I'm just going to use login with my GitHub account. Now click on this login with the GitHub. So once you click on this, it will try to log into my GitHub. So it is, I already have my GitHub account. So it is asking all the details. Authorize Cypress IO. Yes, I'm just clicking on this option. And once you click on the option, now you have successfully logged into the Cypress. Logged into Cypress means, so if you just go back again, once you again go back to your test runner window, so it is saying login successful. Okay, and then click on the continue. So once you continue, now the project setup is done. Setup project. So this is your project name, and who should own this project? So currently me, I'm selecting the me, and it is saying, it is showing two options, public or private. So public means anyone can see your project, anyone can see your recorded videos and screenshot, everything. But the private account means you have to add people to your project, and then only those people can see your project. Otherwise, they cannot access your project. So currently, I'm just taking my private because I'm not going to share with anyone. Or if you want to select the public, anyone can see your project and they can get that project. So I'm selecting currently private and click on setup project. So once you click on the setup project, then you will automatically get one project ID and the command. So these two things are very, very important. And by default, the project ID will be added to your cypress.json file. And if you just go back to your Visual Studio Code Editor, here you will have one configuration file, right? So cypress.json, just open this file. It will automatically add it one project ID. So this is most important. So this is the unique ID which is created for your project Cypress automation. So once you successfully log into the dashboard, so it is automatically created one project ID and it is also given a key. So these two things are very, very important. And this particular command we have to use to run your tests. And in the dashboard, you can see the results, recorded videos, screenshot, everything. So this project ID is by default added to my cypress.json file. There's a configuration file in my folder structure. Now, this is a command which we need to use to run your tests locally. And the results will be saved in the dashboard. In future, also in the CI environment, we can also use the same command. Now, let me just copy this command here. And this command we have to run. So let me run this command. And the command is cypress run, the same command. Additionally, we have to add this attribute --record and --key. So this key we have to add. So project ID by default, it is added to the cypress.json file. Now select this command and again go to the command prompt. So previously we are in the current project, right? So in the same command prompt, we can execute this command, cypress run. So we cannot directly give cypress run, but before that we need to run this from the node module. So let me just run like this. So node module /bin/cypress run and here --record --key. So this command will execute all your test cases. And finally, the results will be generated in the dashboard. In the dashboard itself, we can see the failure screenshot and the recorded videos. Everything is available in the dashboard. So first of all, let us run this command through command prompt and then we will explore the dashboard. So I'm just entering, press enter. Yeah, now it is started running my test cases. It is picking up each and every spec file which are there in my folder structure and let it complete execution. And finally, we will see the results in the dashboard. So let it complete and let's wait for a few more seconds. So my test cases are still running. So make sure these test cases are currently running in headless mode because we have issued the command in the command prompt. Yeah, now it is still executing all my test cases. So once it is executed all the test cases, then we will see the results in my dashboard. I think this is the last test case. Let it complete. All right, now it is completed all the test cases. Now I have failed my intentionally one test here. So just to see the result in my dashboard. So here there are certain tests or spec files I have executed and through command prompt and using this command. So using cypress run --command, I have provided the key of my project. Now, so once the execution is completed, then we will see the dashboard where it exactly it is displaying. So for that, again, we need to go to test runner. So we already opened test runner window. Let me just go to Cypress. And here we need to just go to the runs. Just click on the runs here. So once you click on the runs, it is still refreshing. Just hold on. This is a test and run. So once you click on the runs, it will give you, it's saying 5 minutes ago. So just click on this one. Now again, I'm logging to my dashboard using my GitHub account. Right, so now here you can see all the test results in your dashboard. So this is my personal dashboard area and which is logged in with my GitHub accounts, and Cypress automation is my project name. And under this here, latest runs. So if you see here, final status is failed because even if your one spec file is got failed, the final status will be shown as a fail. So it will give you other information like this. And if you just come down, you can see the browser, OS version, Cypress version, all other things. And now if you just come down here, you will see all the spec files. The login page here, there are different spec files are available. And there is only one spec file got failed. It is giving in the red color and rest of them are got passed. And you can see, you can notice here, this is my spec file name And apart from this, it is also giving the time, how much time it is taken for execution. And here, this is the output. If there is any failure, we can just click on this output. It will give you the log. If I just click on here, it will display the log where we can see why it is getting failed. So it is getting failed because of this one. So timeout retrieving, expected selective flight, Mercury 2. This is expected title, but this is actual title. Sorry, this is expected title, but it is actual title. So both are mismatching. So that's the reason my test case got failed. So we can just click on this output. It will give you the log why it is getting failed. This is one thing. The other thing is, as soon as my test got failed, it will also automatically capture the screenshot. The second column after the output, you can see another column. These are screenshots. So on pass, there are no screenshot. Only on the failure, it will capture the screenshot. If I just click on this, it will give you the screenshot of the page. So it will automatically capture the screenshot. And apart from this, it will also record the video of every test, even though it is passed or failed. For every test, it is recorded one video. So if you want to play this video, just click on this. So I'm just clicking on the first one, or you can just click on the first test.spec. Just click on the video. It will start playing it. So you can see here. So this is a video recorded for our test case. Done. So if you want to just see end-to-end flow of your test, you can just click on this video link and it will play your recorded video of that particular test case. So how many spec files you have executed and whatever the test cases we have written inside the spec files, for all of them, it will capture the screenshot on failures, and also it will capture the recorded videos of those tests. So this is another beautiful feature or service which is provided from dashboard. So we can see past test cases, failure test cases, and along with this, we can also see the how much time they are taken, and also we can see the logs in the output, where exactly it is failure, and then we can see the screenshot and also recorded videos. So these are the important services we can use from the dashboard. And the dashboard is basically cloud-based service which is provided by Cypress. So we cannot see this report in the local system. So it is automatically generated in the cloud environment, because it's a cloud service. And to log into the dashboard, we can use either GitHub account or you can use a Google account. So it is tightly coupled with your GitHub or Google accounts. Okay. So this is how we can work with the dashboard feature. Only thing is we have to run your test cases using this command, but we need to pass a command --- record argument along with this key. And as soon as you created your setup, as soon as you set up your project first time, you will get the key and the project ID. So that project ID also should be there inside the cypress.json file. So this will automatically added by your Cypress when you set up in your project. In future also, if you want to run this project as a group, as a parallel, or in the CI environment, you have to use this project ID along with the key which is generated by the Cypress dashboard. So these two things are very, very important. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. We have seen how to run our tests in command prompt, or all the tests, or single test. Similarly, we have seen how we can run tests and how we can see the results in the dashboard. And we have also seen how to capture the screenshot and recording. So these two are inbuilt features in the dashboard. We don't need to write any separate code for capture screenshot or recording the video. All right. So thanks for watching. So that's all for this video.